bazaar. So we arrived at Likoni Market. Likoni Market is at the other side of Mombasa. Like after boarding a ferry and crossing over, this is the market you find.
So this market is rich in history because it's one of the oldest markets in Mombasa. Yeah. And almost all Mombasans, you know, shop here, the market here and everything. It's notoriously famous for all kinds of various activities, you know. Just like I will show you on this video. So come with me, guys.
Wana nini?
Yeah, so guys, we just arrived at a nearby cafe, a new Paradise Cafe, and we've made order for a couple of meals. For lunch, I'll be sharing with you on this video. Yeah, so I'm kind of starving right now, so I can't wait to get into eating. So come with me, guys.
Let me go, yeah.
Hi, Antoine, sister.
This is called biryani, chicken biryani, and this is called pilau. So this is just a rice made in the Kenyan culture, raw way. And okay, I think I tasted this once before, but I'm yet to taste this, guys. So I can't wait to get into it and share the reaction with you.
Yeah. We have to be able to imitate like fans around us and kind of like that energy. We have to feed off each other because we're not going to get that from any outside like audience or anything like that. Well, that's all we had for news on KTN News. This continues. Remember those by-elections in Kambakos.
A little bit salty.
Continued voting is underway. Our reporters,
well sourced and prepared.
On the ground.
Especially when you're cooking it with tomato. KTN
News, shopping. I'm asking.
Super pissed, guys. Awesome. Like I said, I've tested it before. I can't wait to have you. Yeah. More coming, guys. This is a roasted chicken. And this is the fried chicken. One thing about Kenyan, it's very hard for you to find Kenyan eating without having this combination of vegetables, like onions, tomato, and some chili. So you just make your eating very complete and blended. So,
star 811 star 800 hash.
Wonderful moment. This restaurant is just somewhere along the road. They have amazing food. Extremely delicious, extremely tasty.
So guys, from the convenience of your mobile phone, stay up to date with the latest hot topics of the town at the palm of your hand.
Wonderful color.
Today is called The Small Businesses. We tell the stories of success, of failure, and the lessons that we have learned from small businesses.
Discuss and answer business and finance news from across the country and the world.
Because we know these matters are important to you, we take a deep dive to go to the movers and the shakers of the market to bring you matters that matter to you in a way that matters to you. On Business Today, we naturally tell you about what's happening on the consumer.
You know, when you have varieties of food, you don't even know the net to go for.
Connect the dots and
it's just a combination of things. Tastiness. Everything on this table tastes amazing. Like, I'm not sure what this is. I think it's tomato, potato kind of like, I don't know. But I'm going to see.
Welcome back. You're watching News Desk. Several schoolheads in Kakamega County have confirmed that students steal books whenever schools are closing, which they then sell to vendors. The books are then sold at the hand stationery along the streets in Mumias.
This is a memory moment. I mean, everything just tastes amazing. I don't even know which is the next story to go for.
Tell us more.
I mean, I'm having fun, guys.
You should only have allegations that there is a syndicate comprising of high school students who steal books from different schools and go to sell them in the black market.
So, you guys, I'll see when I finish this thing.
Students from St.
Louis
police station and allegation that they have been found with stolen books, which are about 300
guys, I'm pretty full. They fall all the way. Massive, extremely tasty. I mean, what the experience. I was sweating all the way, guys. Yeah. Plus, the Mombasa as a county, really a hot place, you know, so you get sweat quite easily, especially when you're involved in an activity. Yeah, so I'm pretty full, but still, we have to find another place to see where we can eat. You know, we're trying to explore Mombasa food, as you guys know. So, we're leaving now to find another stop where we can find Oliver to eat. So come with me, guys.
Elders from Baringo, Turkana and West Pokot have signed a peace agreement to end hostilities.
You have not seen the money? Abiyu Ahmed, I pay double. We go, Sammy.
Guys, it's beginning to drizzle. Yeah, it's beginning to drizzle, like it wants to rain. And that's one thing about the weather of this side of Mombasa, because it's very close to the sea. So it rains serially. Yeah, so we have to round things up before the rain gets heavy. Yeah. So, but meanwhile, I would like to show you more of what happens here before it rains, you know, properly. So you come with me. So guys, this is another stop. You know, when you are in a strange, a different environment, you want to try everything you see. So this looks, for me, it looks inviting. I mean, these are purely mangoes, but they have a cultural way they eat their mangoes. Like they just had some pepper powder on the mango. So we're gonna try it and see how it goes. Do you have some pepper? Do you have some more? Do you have some more?
Pili pili
powder. Yeah. Exactly. Oh my. Yeah, guys, this is purely tomato, but you know, they just have some pili pili powder. So we'll see how it goes, guys. It's a little bit salty. Okay, the pepper is not really that hot, but the combination of the pepper and the mango just gives it this very different taste. You know, when you bite one, it melts in your mouth like you just want to have another bite quickly. You just want to have another bite quickly. So it's worth the experience. Worth the experience. You can try this as well. Do you get this in Nairobi?
Not like this.
Not like this. So what is this? We're gonna get to another stop and see what's going on. Else we can see.
Thank you.